Mitzi is as old as time and is immortal, so that's important for you to know. I am only as old as the hills. I'm not as old as Mitzi, nor as wise. So that's, you know, I do what I can, but you can't beat pug knowledge. I feel like she'd be more likely to be a werewolf, but I would like to see her flapping around, so that would be important. She's very huggable and very cuddly. That's Hunter's nose. He doesn't know what's happening, so he's sticking his nose in because he's worried. So much fun at the wedding. The wedding was awesome. It was super duper cool. Saw lots of nice people. Had fun with Matt. He did dance and I missed it. We had one of my cousin's cousin's kids who loves Matt. Got him to go. Thank you. I did do my eyebrows before this, so thank you for noticing. I did meet Hosier. Hosier's really nice. I cannot sing like Matt, but who can? Who can sing like Matt? It's really weird that there's a lag on this. Yeah, Matt's good at Snapchat. Ooh, someone invited a lot of people. Hello, Ricky Ortizbo? I'm trying to see if people are saying stuff. I was just talking about the wedding. So yeah, Hosier was really nice. He just happened to be... Oh, I used to have a Snapchat. I'm not good at Snapchat. Never reply to people. I just click on things because of the notification. And I'm not a good Snapchatter. I'm too old. Is that Mitzi? That was Hunter. But, This one is Mitzi. She's a special girl. She looked like a melting frog, but I love her anyway. And she loves her mama. And that was Hunter. With little dogs. And that's okay. Yeah, as I said, Mitzi is as old as time itself. I am only as old as the hills. It was good. We went out to brunch. There was a Mother's Day brunch with everyone who was in from out of town at the hotel where they were staying after the wedding. So that was good. I'm glad your internet's working, Lucia. Lucia? Can't say. I can't read. That's another thing you should know about me. Can't read. Lucia is very cute. I'm not going to argue with that. Her muzzle's gotten very gray, though, which is weird since she's a phoenix and will never die. She'll just kind of burst into flames and then be born again. Lucia, got it. Like a chia pet. Got it. Will not forget that. That's a lie. I probably will forget. yes, I am in Philly. I'm glad your dog is watching. I always like to see pictures of dogs. Anytime you want to tweet me pictures of dogs, it's a good idea. Never a bad idea. Thank you. I did them for the wedding. They match my toes right now. I always have my toenails painted, but usually have my fingernails painted too. Yes, graduation is Thursday. Crazy. I do miss seeing that all the time. Yeah, this is what we call the papa chair. This is a very important chair. This is prime real estate in our house. We used to have this big, awesome red couch, but I can't figure out how. For some reason, I keep cutting my own head off. There we go. We used to have this big, awesome red sectional, but it was too big. I really hope you heard Hunter burp. That's going to be the highlight of my you now, was Hunter's burp, and I don't even know if any of you guys heard it. But yeah, this is, again, the good old papa chair. Used to get no love when we had the big red sectional, and now it's the place to be. Hello, everyone who is here. Hello to your cat, Lumpy Leo cat. Hello, everyone. I used to have a cat when I was little, and her name was Princess, and Matt had a cat named Oliver. And then as I got older, my body decided it would be fun to be allergic to cats. So I'm allergic to cats now. I have a bunch of half-siblings, but I only grew up with Matt. Thank you. I am marvelously good-looking. Thank you for pointing that out. Ooh, that's a big cat. Oliver used to be a big cat. Hunter is like 116 pounds, so he would be a very large cat. I know, there's a weird lag on mine too. I don't know if it's just because the internet in my house is not great, but this is only 8 pounds when I got her, so she's gotten much, much bigger. She's still very small. Ready for class mare now, that's ambitious. I am a perpetual school goer, so I appreciate that. I am very worried about not being in school anymore. That was Hunter throwing his dog bowl on the ground to let us know that he is indeed ready for dinner. He will do that any time of the day or night to let us know that he's ready to eat. I'm also having trouble not, like, making this face the whole time. Maybe I should just go for it and just talk like this. I am much, much older and significantly wiser than Matt as well. No, I am actually almost 2 years older. I would say in some ways the stress is gone, and in other ways it's much, much more stressful because I know how school works, and I know how to be a student, and I'm very, I don't know about applying for jobs. My undergrad degree is in English, and then I went back and got a master's in art education because I like to do things I like rather than plan to have any money. Be bored forever. Would I change gender every time I sneeze or be sexually attracted to strawberries? Ooh. I'd go with the gender thing. I think that would be a lot cooler. Yeah. Boyfriends plural. That sounds I don't have enough energy for that, no. So that's a no to the plural boyfriends. I like little kids, but not in, like, an elementary school setting. I like working with them. Like, I used to work at the Clay Studio in Philly. Really awesome place if you're ever in town. And teaching classes there was fun. But to actually be an elementary school art teacher is, like, exhausting. I will take the work if I get it. But I like working with high schoolers. I think eventually I do want to be a college professor. So I'll go back for a PhD at some point. This is hard to, like, answer all these questions and also read about. Why are you upset about the choir concert, meteor showers? Yes, we can be BFFs, Kenzie. I moved to Philly in 2007. Matt came in 2009, and Mom came 2 or 3 years after that? 2 years after that? We are from Long Beach Island, New Jersey. Oh, yeah, they are. I mean, the little kids are really sweet, but if you get a good group of high schoolers, they're cool, too. And, like, little kids, when you're teaching them art, there's so much stuff. Like, they just make a lot of stuff all the time, and you just have to find a place to put all the stuff and not lose all the stuff. I don't know. I have, like, a very love-hate relationship. Oh, that's why you're sad. Well, this is not that exciting, so don't be that sad about it. I have a love-hate relationship with Philly. Detroit, I love Detroit's airport. I will say that for Detroit. I'm making myself laugh. No one else thinks that's a joke. We've lived in Philly for a long time. I don't think the fear of somewhere being dangerous is that upsetting. I don't know. I never really planned to be in Philly. I wanted to go to school in LA, and my parents tricked me into looking at a school in Philly, and I fell in love with it, and I wound up going there for undergrad. I'm not sorry I did. I just never planned to be here at all, much less for this long. Oh, hello, Metric. Is that actually you? Yeah, they did. We were taking a drive, and they're like, oh, let's take a walk around here. Is that an admissions office? What the heck? The one in Lake George? I don't know. That sounds really far away. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what happens with Philly. I'm trying to figure out now where I should start applying for jobs because I would like to be out in LA with Matt, but then I have to figure out, you know, how to have a car and where to live. Apparently there's dogs here. Yeah, I'm in the process of posting some new shows for Matt that are very exciting. I have been to Delaware before. One of my best friends from college is from Wilmington. So I have partied it up in the Wilmington Country Club, I will say. I don't remember what I was answering before. Oh, I'm posting new shows for Maddie. He will be playing in Lake George with Chris Jameson on a Sunday, and it will be very exciting. And they will also be judging a Battle of the Bands. It's a several day long festival. They are only playing Sunday, but they will be there the whole time. Then I'm actually right now in the process of putting up shows on the website. Matt will be opening for, you ready? Andy Grammer and the American Authors, or just American Authors. I'm not going to start putting the in front of things that don't have the, like, some kind of an old, uncool person, even though I am an old, uncool person. This is my time. Get out here. Yeah, I mean, he'll be in Philly for my graduation, but he's really upset about it that he has to fly back and forth so many times because he hates flying. Yeah, Matt really hates flying. But here's a fun thing. You know that Matt is on a plane if you just get a random text that says, "Hey, what's up?" And that's it. He does not like to be on the plane by himself. Thank you for saying I'm not old or uncool. I feel both. Yeah, Andy Grammer is really awesome, and so are American Authors, and I think Matt's going to have a lot of fun. He's doing 6 dates with them around. I know the first one is in New Hampshire because I just typed that one up. The rest of them I would have to double check on. I could actually look and tell you real quick. They are going to be in Louisville, Kentucky, Oshkosh, Wisconsin, Fargo, North Dakota. I think that's it. Was that 6? 1, 2, 3. That was only 4. I missed 2 somehow, but it's going to be 6. That's what I'm under the impression. That Matt is going on a little baby mini tour with American Authors and Andy Grammer. Does it ever bother you that all of us McFanders come? Nah, you know. I mean, again, you guys know my goal is to be famous for no reason, so if I just have to answer questions about Matt, I can handle that. That's, you know, not that hard. I love his fans. Are you kidding? We couldn't make him stop talking to you even if you were sick of him. That's, you know. Yeah, well, you know, apparently it's not as easy to book shows in LA as it is in Philly. Apparently, that's what I've been hearing. It's apparently there's this whole process, and you have to have like a booking manager, and it's like tiers and layers of people that have to contact. And in Philly, it's just like, hey, can I play a show here? Sure, you have to sell tickets. And I don't know. Yeah, but it's cool. Yes, of course I love you. You say you're old, but you're beautiful and look so young. I'll pretend. Smoke and mirrors. And a lot of this angle. I love you, Nicole. What up, Max Barraza, 35. I know, Matt needs to play in LA. I agree with that. I'm sorry. Yeah, no, it's funny. It's weird having him far away, but I'm excited that he's getting to go around and play a few little dates. Yes, I did. I love you, Nicole. And he has played a few shows in New York. I'm happy. Oh, thank you. I drew them on very nicely. Thank you for appreciating. Oh, you know, maybe New Mexico. Why not? Do I have any tattoos? No, but it is thanks to me that he got that square rather than get signed. On his neck was his original plan, and it was thanks to me that it was a square instead, because as Cosmo so nicely put it, I told him that idea was hot garbage. So you're welcome, fans. Thank you. My face is, yeah. I just try to siphon off Mitzi's wisdom, honestly. That's what I try to do. Yeah, no, he knows my plan was better. He's, you know, he gets it. Yeah, I had been hoping to get a tattoo and had researched a bunch of places, and then he just kind of got one and just kind of kept getting one and going back, and I don't have any yet. Thanks, Matrick. I don't understand these numbers in front of people's names. I don't understand almost anything about you know, I'm not gonna lie, this is my first time on here. I will be honest, I have never watched one of Matt's You Nows. I am not a good McFandrew at all. Does Matt look like a bear? I don't think he's hairy enough to be a bear. I'm gonna be honest with you, he can't grow a beard, so I don't think he'd be a very good. I don't think he'd be a very good bear. Yeah, I am a fake fan. Well, there are levels? What? How do you get to different levels? He is tall, that's fair. I don't think he has enough girth, though, for true bear status. I think you need a little bit more heft. Heft and girth. These are important. By communicating or brought... Oh, interesting. I'm at 82%, and apparently I'm... number one on Mare now, so I don't think that means anything important, but I am 5'6". I always think Matt's not that much taller than I am, but I was standing next to him, and I come up to about his shoulder, so yeah, it's just all on his head. Oh, that's interesting. 4'5". Yes, Hozier is so sweet. He's a really, really nice guy, and he remembered Matt, was happy to see him. And there were a bunch of people from his band there as well. They had just flown in, and were getting ready to do something in Philly. I don't like why are so bad at this. Yeah, which is really nice. Very tall. He makes Matt look not that tall. But yeah, Hozier was very nice and very cool, and his cellist bought me a drink. So good night. I would like to move to LA eventually. But we shall see. I can tell you it's not there yet. I have not mailed out any merch, so don't go looking for it. I, like, started panic stopping checking emails because I was sick for my last 2 weeks of student teaching and still managed to go every day and finish all my classes and get a professional portfolio put together, so I have not done any merch. For a long time. No. My hair's straight. I mean, my hair is like a little bit wavy, but it's straight. It's not like Maddie's. Hozier was at the hotel where my out-of-town family was staying, so it was the after-party after the wedding. I liked telling people instead when everyone was like, why was Hozier at your cousin's wedding? I was just like, because Matt wasn't famous enough. Obviously, we needed a better celebrity. Can't just have a McAndrew wedding without a big name. I'm really bad at figuring out how to turn the camera. Not good. I don't know what that's supposed to be, Kyle. It just looks like some weird gray boxes. If it's abstract art, I support that. But, you know, it's okay. I don't really know what to tell you. Yeah, I am. I'm doing a little better with the not panicking. But I'm eager to get back on Merchmare. Best memory with Matt. Oh, no, that's a hard one. There's a lot of, you know, we spent our whole childhood and part of adulthood together. It was nice when I first started driving, and we would have drives back and forth to high school with each other, and he only really likes to tell a story once, so he would tell me about his whole day in the car ride, and then we would get home, and my mom would say, oh, how was your day? And Matt would be like, I already told Mary, just ask her. So, yeah. Oh. Sorry. It's Mitzi snoring, actually. Yeah, it's Mitzi snoring. I was holding, I think, the little built-in mic too close to her. I'll try to hold it closer to me, and then maybe you can hear me better. Is that better? Yeah? Yeah? No? Maybe? I don't know. I can't believe people are actually watching this. I'm thinking, like, another 5 minutes, maybe? Do you have anything else you really want to know about? No, I know it wasn't in the middle of the night. Very impressive. Do you guys want to tell me about yourselves, and I'll answer? It's funny. A lot of my students were asking me about whether this hurt or not in elementary. I mean, it hurts, but it hurts for like a second. And as long as you go to a good piercing shop, it's not bad. What am I having for dinner? I don't know. I just had some cheesy focaccia bread from Trader Joe's, and I'm worried I used up all of my calories now. Because I'm trying to be on a diet, so I don't know. I might have a salad or some soup. what were Matt and I like in high school? In elementary school, when we used to see each other in the hallways, we would high five sometimes. In high school, sometimes we would sneak and eat lunch with each other because we had two different cafeterias because we went to a really big high school. I like Maroon 5 also. I know that you're a songwriter, but you, I remember that. Yes, that's my only sibling. Tree creatures. Yeah, I have no... Everyone's asking, like, what's going on in my life, and I don't know what my plans are, so maybe I will wind up at Lake George. Who knows? The boys' after party was amazing. It was Willy Wonka-themed, and there was a Willy Wonka impersonator there, and amazing food and drinks, and it was just super-duper fun, and there was just a full band set up on the stage, and just whoever wanted to go up and jam could. And it was really cool and great. How do I know what? Wait. Oh, Matt gave you your first check. Oh, that's nice. The first check, Matt hoodie. I read back and figured out what we were talking about. Yeah, no, it was the voice after party was really fun. This wedding after party was also really fun. It only had Hozier and Matt, so two people from the voice. Yeah, I have half siblings, but Matt's my only sibling that I grew up with. I have not ever been to Lake George. I'm trying to think, maybe the only place I've ever been in New York is New York City? I don't really know. I haven't even spent that much time in New York City. I, like, revealed the other day to some of my friends that I have never been to the Met, and they were all, like, appalled, so I probably need to go to New York sometime soon. Matt's not actually shy. At all. He gets tricked and sometimes thinks he's, like, shy. Just like he thinks he can't dance, and he totally can dance. He's a fine dancer, but I still remember the first wedding that he decided he couldn't dance. My best friend, Kat. Well, Kat and I are definitely best, like, really good friends, but her best friend is Jess. So Kat and Jess are best friends. My best friends are Mitzi and Hunter. They are both dogs. And that's great. I would really like to get a PhD because I don't want to stop going to school and I want to teach kids in college, so a PhD sounds like a good idea. Yeah, Matt especially says he loves me if he thinks he's dying, which is somewhat frequently. But yes, Kenzie, you are my best friend. And you as well, Steph_yo. My BFFs. Wow, 46. That's high. These numbers are impressive. Where is your dog? What happened to your dog? Is it okay? Our dogs used to try to run away sometimes, and we would get them back with pizza, because Matt and I always had pizza. Just all the time. Just always pizza. Because why not? When Matt and I first moved in together, I got fat because we used to have second dinner all the time. It was great. It was so much fun. We were like hobbits. We just ate nonstop. All right. Any other cool questions? Because we're coming up on 25 minutes, which seems like a weirdly long time for me just to be talking to you. I feel like I should be singing or dancing. Goodbye, Jess. Because hobbits are wise. Hobbits know what's going on. Hobbits have it figured out. There is so much new merch in the works. Before I got sucked into the end of school, there were a bunch of things that I started planning and getting designs made up for. I've been working on some designs myself that I'm really excited for. We're also talking about doing some other new items. I'm not sure. Would you guys buy clean canteens? I really want to get clean canteens, but I don't know. I'm worried they won't sell. So, like, spread the word that you want clean canteens. Check Matt Clean Canteens. Yeah, but I have a bunch of new designs. I'm just trying to decide, are we going to, like, spread them out and do, like, one a month? Or is it just going to be, like, a blowout or whatever? Right now, Matt doesn't have anything booked in California, I don't think. Even in LA. But yes, new merch is coming, and we're gonna do pre-orders also. So that's gonna be a thing that happens. hoping to eventually get some posters in the works, but posters might be only at shows. And now that he has a tour coming, we get to design a tour shirt. Ah, so exciting. Yeah, I need to remember to be better about Facebook. I'm like, not. Oh, Clean Canteens. K-L-E-A-N. Clean. Clean. I'll work on my enunciation. But yeah, I don't know about the posters. Shipping might be weird with the posters. Ugh, shipping is like my nightmare right now. Did you guys know I accidentally went to mail merch out on tax day and couldn't figure out why the post office was insane? And I hung out anyway and made sure I mailed everything, even though it was April 15th. They're going up right now. Andy Grammer announced some on his Facebook, and I'm putting the rest up right now. Is Matt doing his own shows? Or just, right now he's opening for other people. The one he's doing with Chris at that music festival will just be him. I mean, he might have a band, I don't remember. If Patrick's still here, he can probably tell you. I don't know. If you sent Matt's, I haven't answered any emails about orders, I'm sorry. I have a big stack of them printed out now to start working on. I'm getting them out. Thank you, Sierra, to start getting out now. There's nothing wrong with the orders, except I am the only person who does orders, and I haven't had time to do any. So I will be shipping them out. If for some reason you've decided this wait was too long, I cannot accept it. I will refund your money, and we'll pretend this all never happened. And that will be that. All right. One lady show. Yes, I'm going to start booking dates also, where I just jabber nervously at the screen. Yeah, they do try to help, definitely. So if you ever get an item that's completely covered in dog hair, you'll know that it was Mitzi and Hunter who shipped it instead of me, FYI. I think if you look, it's still under his, it's not a post, but it's still under tour dates. I don't know. Yeah, honestly, I, like, can't wear my Scribble crew neck at home because it's just 100% dog hair. So I'm selfishly choosing some things that aren't all black for merch future stuff. Yeah, I'm sorry. I try to make sure there's not, I don't let them in the room when they have dog hair to get on the merch. Sorry, it's hard to read and do this. I was going to make a joke about doing a song and dance that when I was little, I did ballet, and I stopped because I was so bad at it. My uncle called me a ballerina, and I don't think he was very far off base. I couldn't skip as a child and was very fat, so not a ballet-built combination. But yeah, anyway. I don't know that right now, I'm putting up all that I know about. We don't have, like, a crazy number of tour shows booked, so if, like, you're holding out because you're like, oh, this is getting close to my hometown, for right now I can tell you there's nothing else in the works. All I know about is the 6 dates with Andy Grammer and the one in Lake George. Hopefully there will be more coming, but I would say if there's one that you can get to, buy the tickets now, because he'll be fun to see. He always puts on a good show. Or almost always, you know? I'm gonna tell you always, and then he's gonna show up and only have one arm and not be able to play guitar and only be speaking German. You know, you never know with Matt. He's very unreliable. But I'm kidding. Matt's always great. Don't worry about it. If you buy tickets, it'll be a great show. Andy Grammer and American Authors are cool too, so it's guaranteed a good time. So you should buy tickets. Also, oh my gosh, I just realized I forgot to tell you. Apparently everyone needs to be requesting Counting on Love on the radio. That's a thing that needs to happen. So, like, raise your hands if you've heard it on the radio already. I haven't, because I only listen to NPR. I'm going to start requesting that they play it on NPR and see how that goes. I think if he can break into that market, then it's, you know, nothing but net from there. Yeah, so, you know, keep requesting to your pop or your rock or your Matty Mix stations. I don't know what stud is. I know what Q102 is. But, yeah, I mean, again, I'm all on that 90.9 WHYY NPR jazz. So, not jazz. It's just talk radio. Yeah, but, yeah, counting on love. Put out the word. Get the requests in. I'm gonna probably go in a minute and start working on merch. Are you guys watching The Voice tonight? Top 5! Isn't that crazy? It's only, you know, down to just 5. I can't believe it. Who are you guys voting for in the top 5? Who do you want to win? Who do you want to take it home? Bye, Kenzie. Yeah, I know. And Anna Kendrick. And you want Sawyer to win. I understand that. Another Sawyer voter, sure. Whoa, a lot of people all at once. Who do I think will win? I don't know. I'll be surprised. I didn't know that. I didn't realize he was doing 1,000 years. I'll be surprised if Sawyer doesn't make it into, like, the top 2 or 3. I don't know that he'll win. But I think he'll make it into the top 2 or 3. I also really like India. But, I mean, they're all amazing. It's not like there's going to be... That's the thing about The Voice, is everyone's so good at singing that, like, you're gonna have a good winner no matter what. But, you think it's rigged? In favor of awesomeness, sure. Yeah, The Voice is all about rigging for awesomeness. Yeah, we'll see. I don't know. Sawyer's so young, though. I don't know. If I was 15, I don't think I could... Or did he turn 16 yet? I don't remember. I don't think I could handle that when I was that age. Don't be upset about Matt being runner-up, because Matt's not upset about Matt being runner-up. So if Matt's not upset, you're not allowed to be upset. Don't, you know, be fine with The Voice. Just question America. I'm kidding. It was, you know, runner-up was great. The whole show was awesome for Matt. Just think about, you guys, hi, Kim. You guys wouldn't even know Matt if it wasn't for The Voice. And he... could have been, you know, just still working at Trader Joe's, not knowing. He's 16 now. Anyway, all right, well, thank you. I am a wonderful sister. He's one in a million, you know. I did hear they canceled American Idol. That's crazy. I will admit I haven't watched it since, like, season 2, so I don't really feel like I can speak that passionately about it. I was there for almost all of Matt's performances. I think I missed only, like, 2 or 3 of the live shows. Maybe only 2. Because I was in school. But, yes, Mitzi is snoring. I'm trying to hold my laptop up so you don't hear it. So I'll just hold it up and just look up at you guys. That's great. Oh, I love Psych, the show. So, I hope that's what we're talking about. But yeah, The Voice is really nice and I like that. My favorite song Matt performed on The Voice, I really liked Take Me to Church, but he slayed everything he did, so it's hard, and I still can't hear 1,000 years without doing my laugh cry, which I feel like I've done a lot, but goes like, because too many feelings. Anyway, alright, well, I should probably get going before I wear out my... You know, welcome. Oh, I'm allergic to everything. So my allergies are pretty terrible right now, even though I take 4 Zyrtec a day, as well as other medicine. So, yes, the laugh crying is important. But, no, I'm, you know, coughing up phlegm and stuff. But other than that, not too bad. Oh, I love Taylor John Williams. He's really funny. And he's so tall. He's taller than Matt. Did you guys know that? Fun fact, Taylor John Williams taller than Matt. And I was pushing very hard for the man bun the whole show, so I'm happy that... Oh, I'm glad you found your dog. I don't know what we're being appalled at, Kenzie. But, yeah. Well, Matt's 6'4", so I think Taylor is a little bit taller than that. Except Matt always says he's not 6'4", and I always think he is 6'4". But I feel like Taylor John is at least, like, 6'5 or 6'6", because he's very tall. Is there a man in the background? I have the TV on. I don't know. Who always corrects your grammar? Yeah, I think Matt is, he always says, he's like, oh, I'm, like, 6'1/4, because for some reason he thinks that's cool to not be as tall as he actually is. I think he's 6'4", and he will argue with me about this, but I don't care. yeah, well, he's wrong. So, who are you going to believe at the end of the day about how tall Matt is, really? Matt or me? It's me. Yeah, I'm the one. And Taylor apparently also lies about his height, because Taylor is very much clearly taller than Matt, because I remember standing with him at the after party, and he's very tall. Your teacher's screaming about tattoos. yes, I am the right one, obviously. In all of life, I am right. That's what you should know. I'm glad. I want you guys to know I had a backup plan. I was just going to start teaching art lessons if this went really poorly. I was just going to start telling you about René Magritte and surrealism or fauvism or something. That was my panic plan. I want you to know I had a panic plan for in case this went really badly. That was what was happening. So Kenzie and Lumpy Leo seem like they have some stuff to work out. Yeah, that's probably going to come back to me and he's going to be angry about it, but I don't really care. Thank you. Art Talk is cool. So, yeah. I might do more you nows because this wasn't terrible. How about that? That might be a thing. So, unless I have to, this is when height debate 2K15. This is when I would have to separate Kenzie and Nicole. Ask you to sit at opposite corners of the room. No, really, as a teacher, I'd be like, one of you has to come stand by me now. And that would be it. Carrie, Karina, I actually have to message you and ask you about some stuff later. I am as old as the hills, which is 26, on my way to 27. You'll trend mare now for me. Thank you. I'm also happy more than three people showed up. I'm actually, like, stunned. That seems ridiculous. You want to hang out and watch me talk. Anyway. All right, I'm going to go finish posting shows on Matt's website and maybe eat some more food, even though I'm over my calories. Thank you guys for coming out. And, tweet me any questions. And I'll talk to you guys soon. I don't know how to go off of here, so can I just exit out? I figured it out. Okay, bye, good night, thank you. Ask for Counting on Love on the radio. Bye.